Hello, Wacom family, and welcome to our new step-by-step sketch lesson. Did you know that it's correctly pronounced Wacom, not Wacom? Anyway, I'm sitting here in my very comfortable workspace, and I used to draw on my good old Intuos free tablet in Photoshop, as I've been doing for many years now. But of course, you can follow me with any kind of graphic tablet or even with a pen and a piece of paper as well, if you wish. But first of all, I hope that you will have some fun and maybe you can find some helpful tips and tricks for your own future drawings out of this. So I'd say, let's find out. Today I'll draw a female face for you and I'll explain what I'm doing step by step. So let's get started with a circle. But because drawing a perfect circle is really difficult, here is the easy way. First I draw a cross and I mark equal distances from the middle, as it is in circles, and now with some fast strokes around it, here is our circle. So now I also need half of this circle height down here. And some guidelines, cutting the circle into four parts. Now I take the distance from this point to the bottom, and this will be the height of our second circle. Here's the midpoint for the cross, and I can draw my second circle. Now we combine these two circles into a single shape. Fortunately, there are these helpful guidelines inside my shape. Here we got one for the eyes, one for the nose. Here's our mouth. And up here will be our hairline. Maybe I also need some horizontal positions. So I subdivide this line and I got the position of the pupils. By the way, this distance between the pupils can also be used for the width of the mouth. So now for the eyes, we subdivide once more. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And this was our last subdivision for today. Now it's time for one big decision. What is the mood of the person we're drawing? The face can look happy, depending on whether the eyebrows and the mouth are pointing up or down, or, I don't know, angry, whatever. The most important thing for these moods, of course, are the eyebrows. I think this face here should look slightly happy, maybe not too happy, something between happy and neutral. So I try to find the shapes for my eyebrows, not too high. And now our construction is finished, and I personally like to begin with the eyes, because after I drew them, they continue to look at me while I'm drawing the rest. And it seems to develop some kind of a personal relationship between me and the drawing. But of course, you can start with whatever you want, nose, hole, ear. So, as you can see, the upper eyelid hits the pupil here. And the effect is that the face will directly look at the viewer in the end. Maybe this eyelid looks a bit too evil here in the middle. A much more easy thing to draw is the iris. Simply a circle around the pupil. Now for the lower eyelid, to find my line more easily, first I define the points I want my line go through. I want it to overlay the iris down here just a little bit, and on the sides the lower eyelid starts a little further inward. And so now I can find the line very gently, maybe a little upward curve on the sides. Perfect. The next line, I would say it is the most romantic line of a woman's face, the upper lid crease. It is nearly parallel to the upper eyelid, maybe a bit higher towards its middle. So, and now for the eyebrows, my plan is to start with this angle and become flatter towards the side. I use a slightly thinner brush here than before and fill these areas with fast hair lines. And always be careful not to make them too parallel. We can also go for the iris texture a little bit. I'm just approaching this graphically. Some fast lines from the pupil to the iris edge. Maybe some white ones as well. It might be a bit too dark now, so I lighten it up a bit. And finally, one white point for the light reflection. Believe me, I know how to copy and paste and mirror an eye, but I always draw two eyes. Because even if I try to draw them identically, there will always be small differences, and I want these small differences because in life two eyes are never perfectly identical, so that's why I don't copy and paste. The next one is our mouth, and today I like to start with a fast, simple line. This is always a bit of a coincidence, but sometimes, like here, I like what happened accidentally. But of course, the mouth is not only a line. First of all, in the middle, there is a kind of wide V. Upper lip, I start from the edges as symmetrically as possible, slightly ascending. And in the middle of this, we need another V. Just soften the corners a bit. And for the lower lip, I define the bottom and both edges. And try to make the connection as smooth as possible. Just a very light connection line. Now here is a simple formula for instant nose. I draw a flat U for the nose tip. Two reversed U's on both sides. And the nostrils start directly under these reverse U's and go up with a gentle curve. So now I want to adjust the head shape. I start along the upper circle from my preliminary drawing. But here, at the height of the eyes, we need to point our head shape curve a bit inwards. These are the cheekbones, and now I look for the chin. And I want it to be a bit smaller, because it will look a bit more feminine. So from here I go up to hit the shape line. Just have a look. Could be a bit more straight. Done. Same on the other side, of course. And once I finish this, I always use to check it by flipping the face horizontally. Looks pretty symmetrical to me. Maybe I'll do some adjustments later. But first, I will draw the ears, exactly starting at the height of our eyes. So if you ever draw an ear, you maybe have a shape like this in mind. But if we look at a face from the front, our ear should rather look like this, maybe. Otherwise, the face would sail away, I don't know. So I start with a small curve and go straight down at the earlobe. Just a quick instant formula for ears. So now maybe you remember our hairline up here, and I want the vertex to be a bit offset from the middle. And I just let the hair fall down from here. Vertex goes up to the head's edge. Hair is falling along the head shape to the ears. And from here it falls down on both sides. By the way, I forgot the neck down here. Slightly inwards. And we also need this little crease under the mouth and maybe a little shadow to indicate the cheekbone. Now let's add some more hair. When I try to find out some elegant curves for the hairstyle, for me it is important to draw them really quickly, no slow strokes. Now to draw the hair a bit cleaner, I draw it once more by following the preliminary hair. Maybe not really necessary here, I could have been confident with my first try. Well, as you can see, there arise some areas now inside the hairstyle. So I take a thinner brush in order to fill these areas with one or two fast random lines each, only to indicate the direction of the hair. Still only fast strokes. So finally we got our face done now. If we want, we can adjust some details. I'm not really happy enough with the direction of the eyes. They seem to look a little bit to the side. Sometimes it's a bit difficult to see such things before the drawing is done. So this feels like the right time to me to go into these details. There's so many small details having such a great effect on the appearance of a face. Especially the curve of the upper eyelid. I think women can express universes of emotions I've never heard of only with their upper eyelid. I also think this mouth is a bit too happy for me, so I slightly flatten these corners and I think it could be a bit smaller also. Great advantage of drawing digitally. A bit lower maybe. And it's done. Only still need some eyelashes. I really like to forget them. I don't know why. Okay, let's go for it. I start from the left and I use a thin brush again with a sharp end and draw some downward curves, always beginning at the eyelid and going up quickly. You don't need to fill the whole eyelid with eyelashes. Mostly it looks better if you stop around the middle. Just like the eyebrows, I want these strokes not to be too parallel again. Lower eyelashes are about half shorter than the upper ones, and I also stop near the middle. Now in the end, if we want, we can give the face a little bit of a color. But this should be not the main topic of this tutorial. I'm sure that I'll do a special one about this later. Of course, you can't cover all aspects of a creative topic in one single tutorial. I want to go into more details and variations in future courses, like coloring faces from different perspectives, faces of different ages, hair, nose, ears in detail, the male face, and so on. Anyway, this should give you some solid foundation for drawing a woman's face. I hope you had fun and found some helpful tips for your future drawings. I'll see you next time, and until then, I wish you happy painting, stay tuned, get inspired, and always have fun with it.